Anne from the Useless Crafter. So if you've been following me on Instagram, here are, or here's this one at least. This is the little puffy jacket from Old Navy. It was on sale for $10. And I wanted to personalize them because it's for Charlotte and her friends that play tennis together. And so I wanted to put the name on here because they all have the same jacket. So I didn't want them to, you know, get them mixed up and whatever. So in this little section is, it's just like a little rectangle in the pocket. So there's like a designated space. So that's where I knew I wanted to put the personalization. So I'm gonna show you how to do that. And I really do put HTV vinyl on anything and everything. So this, the shell is 100% nylon. I wanted to use glitter HTV because I know that it's easy to work with. And I'm gonna show you in a second on the screen, but the tennis heart is two layers. It's a white glitter HTV and then a green glitter HTV. So I wanted to use the glitter because I wanted to transfer the pieces all onto one transfer sheet and iron it at one time. So I will show you how to do that, but I just absolutely love this little thing. And I used my mini so that I only applied heat where I needed to, and I knew I wasn't going to ruin the jacket if I just did this little rectangular piece right here. So the first thing that you want to do is you want to measure your space so that you know how big your design is going to be. And here's my ruler. So when I measured this little space right here, it's a little bit under 1 inch, and then it is 4.5 inches long. Okay, so that's kind of what we're working with. And obviously I already cut it, so this is to the right size. But what you want to do is you want to make sure that you're, because it's somewhat of a small space, you don't want to make things too complicated, right? So my tennis heart, because it's, you know, a group of tennis kids, it's so cute. Let me show you where I got that from. That's from Creative Fabrica. It's the tennis heart. You can purchase it. I don't know how much it is because I have the membership. So with the membership, everything comes with it, and it comes with commercial usage so that you could, you know, resell and everything else. So I love it because I don't use the images as much as I do the fonts. But I absolutely love having all these fonts at my fingertips, and they're really, really pretty. So, but here's the image. I like this image because it's basically two layers, right? I knew I wanted to make it white and green. So once you download it and upload it into Design Space, this is what we have. So let me show you. This is one of my favorite fonts. It's so easy to read and so easy to work with. It's called Happy Popcorn, and it's from Font Bundles. You can either download the free version, which then you can't reuse it to sell. So you want to purchase it. But let me show you where it is. So in the text box, let's go to Happy Popcorn. And so here it is. And whenever I'm using a small space, I like to use capital letters. I just feel like it's easier to read. They're all about the same height. It just makes things easier and better. So here is my text. I'm going to type in Riley. And what you're going to notice is with it's going to have these little cutouts. Okay, so here it is. I'm going to move it up here and make it really big just so that you could see it. So if you like the spacing on here, now, you know, we only had a small space. So I would go to letter space and decrease the space just so then you can make your letters bigger and you just have more room for the heart and everything else. So here we're decreasing the space. And then what I did was I welded this piece together, even though the letters aren't touching each other or whatever. But I wanted to make I wanted to consolidate the individual letters into one image, into a welded image, because then I can get rid of these little cutouts. All I would do is then you can click on the name, go to contour, and you can deselect these items out. So here's the name. I'm gonna scroll down. It's all these little cutouts that I don't wanna deal with. In such a small space, I don't want to have to, one, depend on my blade to cut properly, and then two, that I weed it properly. So I'm just gonna get rid of all of that. So now I have Riley like this. I'm gonna decrease it to, I should have decreased it to less than an inch. Yeah, I did 0.9, but I should have made it a little bit smaller because it hit the seams. But anyway, you wanna then decrease it to your size. Let me go to upload and bring in my heart. So when I brought in this heart, what I realized that I wanted to do is, it's in two layers, right? It's in, the green is one full heart, and then this little gray that I wanna turn into white. So let me change the color of that really quickly. So I'm gonna change that to white. So I'm doing HTV. I don't want a layer because I don't want to add that extra layer. I kind of wanted everything sliced out. So what I did was, here are my here's my two layers. I'm going to grab both layers. I'm gonna slice. So when I sliced, I realized there was something funky going on because the heart wasn't fully all the way to the edge. So I know I want my white to be one piece, right? So here, I'm gonna look at this. Here's my white, here is my other white. I'm going to actually weld it together so that my white is thicker. So there's my white piece, and then here is my green piece. My green is in a couple layers, so hold on. Let's get rid of the slice results, right? So we don't need that. But here's my green now. My green now fits perfectly in the heart. And that's what I want. So now that my piece is cut properly, what you wanna do is you just wanna grab the heart and make it smaller. And now we're just sizing to make sure it fits in our little pocket or our little rectangular panel. So, oops, let me undo that. And what you can do is you can grab these two and group it, so that it always moves together. So when you're resizing, it's resizing both of them at the same time, both layers. So here's my heart. I need to make it just a little bit smaller, and then I'm gonna duplicate it. Here's my other heart, and let's see how big this whole thing is. So the whole thing is 4.1 inches by almost an inch. So let's look at our jacket again and remeasure, because I already forgot. It is, I should make it a little bit smaller because this went over into this and it hit the seams a little bit. Lengthwise, it's totally fine. 4.125 is good because this whole thing is 4 3/4, so 4.75, but I want to probably make it a little bit shorter. So I'm just going to grab the two, and there you have it. Okay, so let's go. I'm gonna delete what I had before up here. Or I guess I could just keep it. Let's go to make it. What you wanna do is you wanna make sure, because you're using HTV, that you mirror. So here are my two hearts. Here is the name, you wanna mirror that as well. So it's three layers. It's a white, a green, and then in this case, the right. So the names I did in a different green. So I did a dark green, a light green, and white. So it's going to be three layers. And then I already have the video on how to iron it. So I hope this gives you more confidence to do things, because I see all the time in my Facebook groups, like, you know, would you use HTV or would you just use adhesive vinyl? If I use adhesive vinyl, obviously it doesn't stick as well. I will put heat on anything, and especially on this. You're not gonna wash this that much. It's not gonna have a lot of wear and tear. So you just need to activate this piece like with enough heat for the glue to work, and it will stay on. And if you can see, like, there's no snags or anything, and it's gonna stay on. And worst case, it's $10. You can always redo it and add whatever comes off. But that's kind of how I feel. And especially for things for kids, she's not going to wear this for more than a year. I mean, I guess if I'm lucky, maybe, but it would be two seasons. But obviously, she's not going to wear it during the summer, so it doesn't get that much wear and tear. So I, you know, I personalize everything that I want to. All right. Let me know feedback, comments, questions, and special requests. I am here. Thanks, guys.